Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, which is your station where you watch and learn. I'm going to take you through chemistry and we are going to discuss acid, base and salts. We will emphasize more on acids first, then later we will look at bases and salts. My name is Mr. Francis Mwangi and I will take you through. By the end of this lesson, you'll be able to define what is an acid, you'll be able to state the chemical properties of acids, and you'll also be able to list down the various application of acids. So what is an acid? According to Alhinius, an acid is defined as a substance that dissociates in a solution to provide hydrogen ions as the only positively charged ions. Bronsted also defined an acid as a substance that donates a proton. A proton is a positively charged particle. What happens in dissociation of acids? We are going to look at that in the following diagram. And in this diagram, we are using H to stand for hydrogen ions and the letter A to stand for an ion due to the that results in the formation of the ionic compound. Now, what is dissociation? In this diagram, we have a compound where we have an aqueous solution which dissociates to give us hydrogen ions and A negative ions, which may stand for any radical, which is a group of ions which exist together with a net charge. Don't forget, radicals can be positively charged or negatively charged. What are some of the common acids that we have? Firstly, we have hydrogen nitrate, referred to as nitric acid. It dissociates to give us hydrogen ions and nitrate ions. Hydrogen chloride is another type of an acid that dissociates to give us hydrogen ions and chloride ions. We also have hydrogen sulfate, known as sulfuric acid. It dissociates to give us two hydrogen ions and sulfate ions. So what are some of the properties of acids? By examining the following reactions, we can be able to understand some of the chemical and physical properties of acids. Firstly, let's look at this illustration here. What are some of the chemical reactions of acids? So chemical reaction of acids is as a result of, first we are going to look at acid base, which is referred to as a neutralization reaction. When acids react with bases, they form as, they give us salt and water. That is, bases are the hydroxides of the metals. So we have the general reaction, that is base plus acid gives us salt plus water. Taking sodium hydroxide plus hydrochloric acid, therefore we get HCl plus water. Reaction with metals. Acids react with metals to provide hydrogen gas and a salt. So they liberate hydrogen gas. And there's not all metals, but metals above hydrogen in the reactivity series. What about the reaction between acids and carbonates? The general reaction is metal reacts with dilute acids to give us salt and hydrogen gas. An example, we can take magnesium plus hydrochloric acid gives us magnesium chloride plus hydrogen gas. Acids react with carbonates to give us salt, carbon dioxide and water. They liberate the gas in a process which we refer to as effervescence. An example is calcium carbonate, which reacts with sulfuric acid to give us calcium sulfate plus water and carbon dioxide gas. The reaction is not the same for all carbonates. A bicarbonate acid will also give us salt plus water and carbon dioxide. For instance, magnesium hydrogen carbonate plus hydrochloric acid gives us magnesium chloride plus water and carbon 4 oxide. What about the reaction of acids with sulfides? The reaction between an acid and a sulfide, results in the formation of a salt, water, and sulfur 4 oxide. There is effervescence, meaning there is production of a gas, similar to the reaction with carbonates. In general, we can summarize that presentation or that illustration with the following key points. The type of reaction that occurs between acids and metals gives us salt and hydrogen gas. And the salt formed depends on the acid used. For instance, if we use hydrochloric acid, we get a chloride salt. If we use sulfuric acid, we get a sulfate salt. If we use nitric acid, we get a nitrate salt. And the salts formed have different properties. What about the reaction of the acid with bases? They react to form salt and water. The products formed are neither acid nor base, hence they are neutral, and that type of a reaction is referred to as neutralization reaction. What about the reaction of acids with carbonates? Acids react with carbonates to form salt, water, and carbon 4 oxide. There is one thing I would like us to look at when it comes to acids, and that is the strength of an acid. There are key terms that we need to understand. One of the key terms is dilute and concentrated acid, and we also need to understand a strong and a weak acid. A dilute acid, simply this refers to the quantity, the number, the amount of hydrogen ions in the solution. If there are few, that acid is dilute. If there are more, that acid is concentrated. But when it comes to strong or weak acid, this only looks at dissociation. For instance, in the acids that we had earlier, hydrogen chloride, nitric acid, and sulfuric acid, they dissociate completely. An acid that dissociates completely is a strong acid. Other acids that dissociate partially, they are weak acids. Now, let's see what are some of the application of acids. Some acids are used in metal surfaces when you are cleaning them. Sulfuric acid is used in car batteries. Acids are used in paint making, and they are also used in making soft drinks. So let's look at a test to see whether you have understood the concept. Write a word equation for the reaction that involves the following: hydrochloric acid and magnesium metal, nitric acid and sodium hydroxide, sulfuric acid and calcium carbonate. You can as well as refer to the following so that you can be able to get the concept much better. Thank you for viewing. You're welcome.